it's Jordan Teen One, and in this video, I'll be showing you how to make this really neat pencil pouch or glasses or sunglasses pouch. So you can see I have three different examples here, and they're all made a little bit different. The main two sides are made the same way, but then it's just the top closure that's different. So in the video today, I'm going to be showing you how to make the main sides, and then I'm going to finish it off by just making this open edge, just finishing off the edge so it's nice and smooth, but it's going to be open-ended. And then I will add a link to show you how to do this button closure, where I've just added this extra flap and a button to close it off. And then I will add a different link to show you how to add a zipper to your creation, which is the way I've done this one. So you can see at the top it has a zipper, and I'll show you that. You just open it up, and then you would put your things inside like that. And you can see how it looks on the other side. And I actually really like the way both sides look, so technically if you liked this side better, you could put these sides together, and then this would be your inside. So it's really a matter of choice. So you're just going to follow along with the beginning part for all three of these. It's going to be this video. And then, as I said, I'll add the links if you want to learn how to do the button closure, and then a different link to show you how to do the zipper. Your band count is going to be determined by how long and how wide you want your pouches to be. Now, for each of these, I used 31 or 32 rubber bands in each row, and then I have 13 rows in total. I have my center chain, and then I have 6 rows on either side going out. So that is a good size for a pen, will fit in there nicely. And then if you have a pencil that's not a full-length pencil, that will fit in there nicely as well. But if you have an unsharpened pencil, and I'm showing that in this upper one, 31 is not quite going to be long enough for you to close it totally. So if you want it long enough that you're going to be able to fit unsharpened pencils, I would say you probably need about 35 bands in length. And if you're going to use this for a glass case or glass pouch, I have a pair of sunglasses here, and you can see that the 31 is plenty long, but I think that it's not quite wide enough. If I wanted to, this is a rather skinny pair of sunglasses. I could definitely fit this in this pouch. It's a little bit snug, but it would go in. But if you have a pair of sunglasses or glasses that are a little bit chunkier, you're definitely going to have to expand the number of rows. So as I said, this is 13 rows in total, counting that center chain. So I would say probably to fit it comfortably, you would need at least 15 rows, possibly even more if you have like the real chunky sunglasses. I'm going to begin by showing you how to make one side of the pouch, and then I will let you finish the second side on your own. And for the total of bands for each of these two sides, I have 549 white, and then I have 62 of each of the 6 rainbow colors. The first thing I'm going to do is make my single chain, and I have a length of 31 that I'm going to be using. So I've counted out 31 white rubber bands. And that's a good length for pens or markers. But as I said earlier, if you're going to want to fit a full-size unsharpened pencil, then you're going to need to have a little bit of a longer chain. So I would say maybe about 35. So I'm going to take my first band, and I'm going to place it on my hook, twist, and put it back on, so that you'll have the two loops on there. And then what I like to do is take a clip, and this is just optional, but I like to take a clip and attach it through those two loops. And that way it just gives me something to hold on to for the base, but it's definitely not necessary. And then I have 30 more bands here that I'm going to chain, so you're just grabbing it with your hook, pulling it through the ones that are on your hook and then back on. So it's really quite easy. That's how you make a chain. And the nice thing is, if you count out your bands ahead of time, then you know that when your pile's gone, that you're done. So if you're used to crocheting with yarn, then you're probably familiar with making a chain, because that's how a lot of projects start out. For example, if you were making a blanket, you would start with a chain for as long as you want your blanket to be. So as I said, this is pretty easy, and the more that you use your hook, the quicker you can get doing these kind of things. I know when my kids were first introduced to rainbow loom, we didn't actually have the loom. My niece had gotten it, and so we had a bunch of packs of rubber bands. And doing a single chain like this was the first thing that they learned how to do. It's really amazing to me to think how far we've come since then, with all of the intricate bracelet designs and now these crochet projects. It really is mind-blowing, the things that you can create. And I actually need to add one more because I dropped one on the floor when I was doing this. So that should be my nice chain of 31. Now I'm ready to begin my first row of single crochet. And since I am going to be following the rainbow color pattern and I'm working from the center out, I want to have yellow be up against the white. So you can see where my hook is on this last one. I'm going to take my yellow, I'm going to pull it through the end of the chain, get it back on my hook, and then I'm pulling one end through the other to make a slip knot. And you don't have to pull that tightly, you can just leave it loose like that. And now if you see where this went in, that's going to be the front part of the chain that you want facing yourself that you're going to be putting your hook through. So we already went in this chain, so we're skipping that and we're moving over to the next chain. Just make sure that it's facing you, the opening. You want your hook to go through from front to back, and you'll see those two loops on your hook. Make sure you make it through both. You're taking your yellow, it's pulling through, and then the other end goes back on, so you have the three loops and one pulls through the other two. And that's called a single crochet. I'm just working my way over to the left. And again, you just pull it through, back on your hook, and one through the other two. So that's all we're going to do for this whole length. And then when you do switch sides, you will have to change where you're going in through. But it's really not too difficult. So you're just going in through, making sure you're going through both loops, pulling that through, back on, and one through the other two. And if you seem to be struggling with this, I do have a single crochet bracelet that I made that is maybe a little bit easier or a little bit slower to follow along with, but I'm going to go a little quicker on this just since it's a bigger project. So it's always just going to be one band in each of the chains. And if you wanted to, you could do more than one color on each of the rows. You would see where you change colors, but it still would have a pretty neat look to it, I think. But for this, I'm just going to stick with the solid rows. And when you're doing this, if your hook happens to slip off, don't worry. It's usually pretty easy to just get right back on. I occasionally have that happen to me. And if you happen to get to the end of a row and you've counted out your bands and you have an extra one or your short one, then you know that something got messed up along that row, so you just need to go back. You can see I just messed up there. It slipped off, so I'm just putting it right back on. Just need to go back to that row and look at your design and see if perhaps you put two bands in the same chain, or maybe you skipped a chain by accident. Usually you'll definitely be able to tell if you've skipped a chain because it looks bunched up there. And as you're making this, it is going to curl up a little bit. You can see here it's not completely straight, but don't worry about that. The more rows that you add, the more straight it comes out. Even though it does have a little bit of flexibility to it, so it's not always going to lay 100% flat. So it looks like I have four left here. So I can see that my count is working out, so I know I didn't have any errors in this row. Going through that last one all the way to the end here. So you can see how it's starting to look. And now what I'm going to do is to flip this completely over so that my hook is once again starting over on the right. Now for this second row, I'm switching back to the white, and I have a total of 32 rubber bands counted out. And as I said, we flip this here, so your hook should now be on the right. And so this time you're going to want to go in through the back. Before, when we had it this way, we were going in from front to back. But since we flipped it and that's now facing the back side, you still need to be going in through that side. So I find the easiest way is to hold it straight up so you can see the top here of what I'm calling the stitches. And each stitch is like a V shape. It has two loops, a front and a back. So what you're going to do is from the back, and you are going through this very first one here that your band is through, that your hook is on. You're going to go through that. So you can see I went through the two loops there, taking my band. I'm going to pull it through, and now since we are changing colors, what I'm going to do is something called a slip stitch. So normally you just put this back on your hook and slide it through the other two, but since we want the yellow to be against itself, I'm going to go through the yellow first, then put the white back on, and then just you have the two loops and one goes through the other. And then also I'm going to go through this same loop a second time. So again, from the back, I'm going through these same two loops, that same stitch. I'm taking a second white, pulling it through, and this time it's just back to regular since they're all white, and one pulls through the other two. So the reason I'm doing two on the end is just to try and get this a little bit more even, because we want a straight edge to be at the end. So now you're just going to work your way over to the left. You're going through the two loops there, pulling through, back on, and one through the other two. Just going to follow that pattern the whole way down to the end. So it's really just the same thing we were doing with the chain, only this time we have that stitch to go through. I know if you've never done the crocheting before, sometimes it can be a little bit confusing as to where you want to be going through. But I think once you do it a little bit, you'll definitely get the hang of it and see where you need to be going. Sometimes in certain projects, you'll want to just go through one of the loops of the stitch. For example, in my Easter puff basket, when I want to separate the bottom of the basket from the sides, I only go through one of the stitches to create that. But for this project, we are going to be going through both loops of the stitch every time. And again, you can see how this is curling, but don't worry, it'll flatten out some. You can already see with the ones that I've done how much flatter that's become. And I think the quality of bands that you're using definitely has a lot to do with it too. I prefer to use Rainbow Loom brand bands because I think they are a better quality. And I do like the fact that they're a little bit tighter than some of the other bands. So when you're doing a crochet project like this, I think it just looks neater and tighter when your project is finished. And then I also like the fact that the bands glide against each other fairly well. Sometimes you'll find that bands are like really rubbery and they don't want to go against one another when you're pulling it through. And I sometimes find that to be a problem. But not everybody has access to Rainbow Loom bands. I know a lot of people, especially if they live out of the United States, have a hard time to get the colors that they want, or the shipping costs are very high. So I know that that plays into it as well. And as a matter of fact, some of the colors that I am using today are not Rainbow Loom, just because I didn't have access to them when I needed them either. So like my yellow, for example, is not Rainbow Loom, and I don't think the purple is either. So it looks like we're down to the last four here. And you can see I have two left, but this is my last stitch. So I do want to put two in this last stitch, so that would be the first one. And I'm going back through again, and I'll do the second. So again, I'm just adding the two at the end here just so it evens out. And then once again, you're going to flip this. So this time I'm changing to orange, and I have a total of 31 bands. And so again, your hook is going to be on the right, and this time, since where we started is facing us again, we want to be going in through the front. So again, I'm going to go in through this first stitch where my hook is through, from front to back, taking my orange, and since we're changing colors, we're doing that slip stitch. So I'm pulling it through, and then also going through that other white, and then getting it back on my hook. So you have just the two loops and one goes through the other. And now for this row, we're just doing one single crochet in each stitch. We're not adding that extra stitch at the end. So again, just from the front, I'm always going on this row, pull it through, back on, and do that single crochet. After doing several rows of these, I'm sure everybody will definitely be in the swing of things here with how it works, if you haven't already done it before. So depending on how quickly you go, depends on how long it's going to take you to make this. And it's definitely a longer project to do, but as you get more comfortable with the crocheting process, you can definitely move along a lot quicker, so it won't seem to take you nearly as long as if, say, this was your first bigger project. So I think after I'm done this row and then I start the next row, I am going to begin fast forwarding through the main sections here, the center sections, just because it's going to get really long and I find this is really pretty straightforward. It's not really anything new, so I think it's probably best if I do move it along after this. So I don't know about anybody else, but I really enjoy doing this rubber band crochet. I find it very relaxing. A lot of nights when I sit down in front of the TV after the kids are in bed, I like to work on this. And as a matter of fact, I find it kind of odd to just sit down and watch TV anymore without having rainbow loom or rubber bands in my hand. I feel like I'm missing something just because I'm so used to doing it. And we're getting down here to the end. Looks like we have three more. And then the last one. And then again, you're going to flip it around so your hook's on the right. And now for this next row, again, I'm switching back to white. I have a total of 32 rubber bands, and I do want to do those two single crochet in the two end stitches. So again, you have this part here facing the back, so you need to be going in from the back. So I'm going through this very end stitch here, taking my first white and pulling it through. And then I also need to do a slip stitch again since I'm changing color, so I'm going to go through the orange and then pick up the other side of that white and pull one end through the other. And I am going to do a second one, so I'm going through from the back, pulling through that second white back on my hook, and now you're just back to a regular single crochet. So then I'm just going to work one in every stitch again until I get to the very end where I'll do the other two. So I'll just go through a couple of these here and then I'm just going to fast forward. I know some people get annoyed when videos get fast forwarded, but really when you have a longer project, it's kind of a necessity, I think. So you can just pause your video here and finish out this row. When I get close to the end, I will show you how to complete the row. So now I'm down to my last four rubber bands in this row, and I do only have three stitches left since I'm doing two in the end here. And then let me just point out, if you look here at the top, it may look like you have two stitches left, but really this very end one is part of the slip stitch, if you look from the front, you can see that we only have one set of bands to go through, but it is a little bit misleading when you look from the top because you see this little half stitch that was part of that slip stitch. So I am going to do two in this final stitch. If you did by chance think that was a stitch and you just put one band in this and then you put your hook through this little slip stitch and put the other band through, it wouldn't be the end of the world. It would still work out. But technically that's not really what you're supposed to be going through. So I'm doing two in that and then I'm flipping it around. So again, hook on the right. And now I'm changing to red for my next row, and I have a total of 31 bands, and I'm just going to do one single crochet in each of the stitches. And again, since we have this part facing us, we're going to be going in through the front. So from the very end stitch, I'm pushing through front to back, pulling through my red, and then I want to also get it through the white, do that slip stitch, get it back on, and pull one through the other. And you may notice that this tends to poke out a little bit, the slip stitch, but don't worry about that. And since we're doing just one in each, I'm moving over to the next stitch and going front to back. And then you're on to just your regular old single crochet. So again, I will fast forward till I get close to the end. And now I have four stitches left and I should have four rubber bands. And I do. It's always a good feeling when your band count and your stitch count work out the way they're supposed to, so you know you didn't make any errors. Here's the last one, and then again I'm flipping, so now this time I'm going in through the back, and now this will be my last row across the top, and I have 32 white bands, and I am going in through the back, so going in through this first stitch, back to front, taking my first white, and I will need to do that slip stitch just because I'm changing. And then I do want to go back in through the same one again. And I can see this red loop from the slip stitch I made, so just try and be careful not to get hung up on that. And then it's going to be one single crochet in the rest of the stitches just till you get to the very end. So again, you can pause here and finish out this row. And now again, I have three stitches left, even though it might look like four because of that last little half slip stitch. And I have four bands. So now in this last stitch, I'm going to do my two whites. So that's one, and then in through there again for the second. And then I'm going to take a clip. I have a C clip here. I'm just going to attach it to this very end loop so I can take my hook out. And then you can see how it's looking. This is half of the first side. Now I'm ready to begin my next row. So I have 31 green bands. And this is going to go in this center chain we're going to be building out from the opposite side. And I'm going to be starting on the same side that I initially started on, and it's going to be the one where your clip is or your loose end is. So I'm going to just go to this center chain. I'm going to go through the first one, And if you look here, you can tell which side you need to go through. So this side here is the one that we started on. So you definitely want to be going in through from the back. So I'm going to just push through those first two loops of that chain. And you don't have any slip stitch or anything like that to worry about. You're just having the two loops. One goes through the other. And then again, it's just going to be one single crochet in each of these chains. Always in from the back. So I like to do it this way by keeping the single chain in the middle because I think it gives it more of a symmetrical look. So again, I will fast forward till I get close to the end. And here's my last two. And then that last one should be in the last stitch. And then you're going to flip it over again. In this next row, I'm switching back to the white, and I have a total of 32 bands. So there's going to be two single crochet in the start, and then two single crochet at the very end. And sometimes when you flip this, you may notice that your bands look a little bit twisted around. And if you do notice that, all you have to do is just twist your hook back around and it'll straighten itself out. And then you can see here by the look of this that we need to be going in through the front. So I'm going to do this slip stitch. And then going back through that same stitch. So I'm doing my second one. And then a whole row of singles till the end. So you can pause here and finish this row. I have four bands left here and three stitches. So in this last one, I have the two. So that's one, and then back through again for the second. And then I'm flipping it over. For this next row, I'm changing to blue. And I have 31 bands. So it's going to be one single crochet in each stitch. And I'm going in from the back side here. So I'll do my slip stitch. And then just continue on with one in each. So I'll let you finish out this row. I have three more left here, so one for each stitch. And then I'm flipping it over. For this next row, there are 32 white bands, and again, it's going to be two single crochets in the end. So I'm going in through the front this time, doing that slip stitch every time, and then going through again for a second. and then one in each until the end. So I'm sure everybody's got the pattern down by now. And you've probably been at this for a little while, but you are getting near the home stretch of this side. So I'm going to let you finish out this row so you can pause here. Now I'm down to my last three bands and I have two stitches left. So in this end one, I have the two. Flipping it over. In the next row, I have 31 purple, so this is my last color row. And I'm going to be going in from the back. And it's going to be one single crochet in each of the stitches, doing that slip stitch to start, and then just working my way to the left. So I am going to just fast forward here. I've got three bands left and three more stitches. And then for the last time, I'm flipping it. So this is my last row on this side, and it's going to be 32 white bands. Again, following that same pattern. This time I'm going in through the front. I'm going to have two single crochet on just the end stitches. So, whoops, I just lost it there. Let me go back in. Doing the slip stitch and then back through the same one. And then just working my way all the way to the end. So you can pause here and finish this row. And now I have three bands left for the last two stitches. And we're just about done here. So I have two for the last stitch. So that's my first one. And then back through for the second. And then I'm going to take a clip and place it on this loop that's on my hook. And then you can see we're done one half of the pouch. So then what you're going to do is just repeat all of these steps again to make the other half. And you might want to take a little break in between like I'm going to do to give my hands a little rest. And so make this other half and then I will show you how to put them together. Once you've completed your two sides, then you're ready to sew them together. So if you're making the zipper closure kind, then the zipper would go across the top. So when you sew these together, you want to start in the top left corner and you would sew down the short side all the way across the bottom and then you would end up on the top right corner. And for that, you'll need approximately 57 bands. And I'm going to be sewing it together the other way, where the pouch is going to be open at the top in this way. So I'm going to start in the top left corner with it facing this direction, come all the way down the left side, across the bottom, and then straight up to the top of the right side here. And that's going to require approximately 75 rubber bands. So you want to have your two panels facing each other so that the colors are matching up. And then when you do that, they're actually going to be opposite of the way you sewed them. So the clips on the one are going to be on the one end, and then the clips for the other panel are going to be on the other end. So that's fine. And as I said, I'm going to start here in the top left corner. So wherever you have a clip with a loose band, you want to make sure that you're getting your hook through that. Let me just turn it this way. So I'm starting on the end here, and I'm going to go through the top stitch here. So it's white. Actually, they're all going to be white. And then I'm going to go through the other one here. And I want to go through the stitch, but I also want to go through this loose band that the clip is through. So first I will go through that, and then I can remove the clip. And then I'm also going to hold this with my finger, pull back, and then I also want to go through that stitch as well. So you're actually going to have three loops on your hook from this side and two loops from the other side. I'm going to take my first band. I'm just going to pull it through all of these, get it back on my hook, and then pull one end through the other to make a slip knot. And I'm just going to work my way through each stitch. You definitely need to have the stitches lined up, so just make sure as you're doing this that you're going through the very next stitch on both sides. So we already went through the one on the end here, so I'm going to move over to the next one. So you're always going to have two loops from the front, and then find that next stitch over on the back side, and you're going to have two loops from that. And then you're going to pull through those four loops back on your hook, and then one slides through the other two. So it's basically the same as like a single crochet, but you're just going through both sides. So then again, you're moving over to the next one. So you're going through the two loops on the front and then the two on the back. It's going to pull through all four back on your hook, and then one slides through the other two. So that's basically all there is to it. The hardest part is just making sure that the stitches are always lining up, making sure you're not skipping any. And then if you get to the end and they don't match, then you know you messed up somewhere and you're going to have to backtrack. But hopefully that won't happen if you're really careful. And if you're not sure if you've already gone through that stitch, what you can do is look to the side. Like if I was moving over here and I'm like, I don't know if I went through that one or not. If you look to the side, it's a little bit easier to tell than looking from the top. And then also when you're pulling through, just try your best not to get hung up on the bands. Like for example, when I'm pulling through these four loops, if you just pull down just slightly on the pieces, it makes it a little bit easier for the band to slide through and not get hung up. So I'm just going to fast forward till I get to the corner so you can pause and continue sewing your pieces together. Now I'm almost to the corner here. I have 2 stitches left. So let me just go ahead and do the next one. Sorry if this clip is in the way of you seeing what I'm doing here. So now I'm at the corner, and I do need to make sure I get this loose band connected. So I'm going to do that first, put that on my hook, take off the clip, and then I'm going to go through also the stitch on the end here. So it might be a little bit difficult to see. I'm just going to go through right here where my band is already on. So I'm going through that opening and then also the other side. So again, you're going to have the 5 loops on your hook plus your additional one here at the end. So I'm going through the first 5, and it is going to be a little bit tight to get through. You might have to use your fingers or just do a lot of hook twisting there. So I made it through all of those, getting this one back on my hook, and it slides through the 2 previous. And then I'm going to turn this around, and I am going to put another stitch in the same spot here because it would be my first stitch working the way up the side. So I just want a little extra support on the corners as well. So I'm doing those 2 stitches. This time you're going to have 4 bands to go through, back on your hook, and then it slides through the other 2. And now working up this short side here isn't quite as obvious as working on the sides here. Since it's a little bit more messy, it's not like a nice smooth edge the way that the longer sides are. But basically, if you look at the colors, I just want to make sure I'm putting 1 stitch in every set of the colors and the whites. So we had 13 in total. So I've already done this corner one for the white. So next I'm going to line up the reds. So I'm going through each of the reds here. And then the next is going to be the white. If you pull it, you can see the opening where you need to go through. The next one here is going to be an orange. And then the next is a white. So then I'm on to yellow. And then I have another white. And of course, if you're using different colors, you're not going to be following what I'm saying here, but next is green. As long as you put a stitch through every row that you've made, I mean, possibly you've made it wider than 13. And then I have white again. Then blue, and I have white, purple, and then at the top corner here, I have another white. And again, I have this loose band that I need to incorporate. So just put that on my hook, take off the clip, and then I also want to go through the stitch part and on the other side the stitch. So this is going to pull through 5 bands. And again, it always wants to get hung up here. Back on your hook and through the other 2. And then you're just going to turn it. And again, I'm going to go through that same stitch on the corner on either side. So you will go through those stitches twice. And now it's just a matter of working up this other complete side. So again, for the rest of this, I'm just going to be doing 1 in each. And I need to make sure that I'm lining it up. So go through the next one and then find it on the back. Again, if you're not sure if you need to go through which one it is, you can see we already went through this one on the end, so it's this next one here. So I'm just going to continue working my way up this side, and then I will show you what to do when we get to the end. I'm down to my last 3 bands, and I have 3 stitches. So I'm just going to go ahead and finish this off here. And then in my very last one, I have this clip again with this loose band. So I'm going through the front side here. And then I'm also going to go through this loose band and take the clip off. And then I also want to go through that stitch, so you're probably going to have to hold this and sort of loop around with your hook, go through that stitch as well. And then you have to make it through all of these bands. So it's 3 bands on the one side, 2 bands for the other. Whoops, I got hung up on one there. Put it back on your hook, and then the one slides through the other 2. And now I just need to tie this off so it's not going to come apart. So I'm just going to go through one side here, take an additional white band, I'm going to pull it through all of these bands so you have just the 2 loops, and I'm going to make a nice tight slip knot so it's not going to come apart. And then you're going to have to hide this, so I would suggest going inside here. I just flip this inside out a little bit, and I'm just going to go through some of these stitches here on the inside edge, and I'll just pull this loop down through. Just so that it's hidden inside there, so you won't notice that. And now the last thing I'm going to show you in this video is how to finish off the edges at the top. If you want to leave your pencil case or glass case open, which should work out just fine since it's pretty grippy, I don't think things will easily just fall out of it. But if you would like to either make the zippered pouch, I'm going to add a link on how you can do that, add a zipper, or if you'd like to make this extra flap and add a button, I'm going to add a link to show you how to do that. So to finish off the top edge so it looks nice and neat, you're going to need 26 additional bands. And so it's really the same concept that we've been using this whole time. I'm going to start on the one side, and I am going to be working on the inside out. So my hook's going to go in from the inside and push out. I'm just going to start on the end here, and I want 1 in each of the white rows and the color rows, so there should be 13 total on one side. So you're just putting it through, getting it back on, and then pulling one end through the other. And then I'm going to go through the red. You can have those three loops, and then one's going to pull through the other two. And then I'll move over to white. And then orange. So just make sure you're going through every single row. So now I'm back to the white. And then I have the yellow. And I have white again. It looks a little squished, but it's there. And then I have green. And back to white. And then I have blue. And another white. And then there should be two more on this row. I have to go through purple. And then finally I have my last one on this side. And so you can see it just gives it a more finished edge there. And so then you're just going to flip this around. And you're going to repeat this on the other side. So again, I'm always going from the inside out. I think it just looks neater on that side. If you did it the other way, it would have this look here on the inside. And maybe you do like that. And of course, you can always leave this side facing out and have this be your inside. Because honestly, either side looks kind of cool. It's totally your preference. So now I'm just going to go around. Again, just lost that one, but, and then I'm just going to follow the rest of the way. So just make sure you're doing one in each of your rows. So I'll let you finish this row on your own so you can pause here. And now I'm down to my last two. So I have one that's going through the red. And then finally, my last white here. And then once again, I'm going to have to tie this off. So I'm going to take an additional white band. And let me just go through here. I'm going to pull the white through all three bands on my hook. And then make a really nice and tight slip knot. And then once again, you're going to have to hide that inside. So I would recommend just going through some of these inner stitches. And then pulling this down through. So here is your open-ended pencil or sunglass pouch. So you can see it's ready for use. It's nice and finished here. So you can either put your sunglasses in, like so, or use it for pens and pencils. So I hope that everyone loves their new open-ended pencil or glasses case. You can always leave me comments on YouTube and Facebook. Post pictures of your creations to my Facebook page, and please feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you can stay up to date on my latest tutorials. You can also find me on Pinterest and Instagram, so please feel free to subscribe to those as well. Thanks for watching!